I'm at least back reporting.
If you were to be a professional in another sport, what sport would you be a pro in?
Yo creo que lucha grecorromana.
What sport is that, Robert?
Wrestling, but Roman,
Olympic wrestling? So you know how to do wrestling?
No.
Oh, you would do it?
Yeah.
Robert, could you coach another sport besides boxing?
No.
Why not?
Maybe Alvin's soccer team or something like that.
Where there's no scores kept and everybody gets a trophy?
I know. You know what?
I think that's wrong. I think winners should win, losers should lose.
Check this out. This is a true story. So Alvin's playing soccer for AYSO here in Menifee. So he's like the only little Mexican in the team, right? It's all white kids. So Alvin's used to playing in Oxnard, where the coaches are like, what the fuck is your problem? You know, you got to do this. You got, you know, go do this, go do that. And right there, he's like, good boy, that's fine. You missed, but you did a good job. You know, shit like that. So even Fabio would be like, what the fuck is wrong with that, with the coaches? So they lost the game. So they lose the game, and the coach calls all the kids after the game, and the coach is like, guys, I want to tell you guys, I'm very proud of you guys. You guys did really well. I was like, why? We lost. Why would you be proud? We lost.
That's he kept story. It 100.
It's
he
true.
Kept it real.
It's true right here, man.
But look, that's
doctor
why...
doctor knows what's up with that.
Listen, that's
I
why...
I coached soccer for 17 years.
In Oxford?
Camarillo.
Yeah, well, see that? Same thing. Good job, guys.
No, we were hard line.
Yeah.
I never had a losing season in 17 years. We that's won good. More than we lost.
There's
every
a.
Season.
I seen a video of a coach. I don't know if it was a baseball team or soccer team or something, but the coach, like they're, you know, like right before the game, he's telling them, those guys, that they want to beat you guys. You guys better, you know, there's no losing in our team. You know, that's the way, I think that's the way it should be.
Well, you need to have, I mean, you don't need to abuse someone because they lost.
Yeah.
The effort to win is important. If you don't put the effort in, you don't deserve it.
Yeah, the coach is telling him, you know, there's no second place with us. My team is not going to be okay.
But here's
with,
the problem.
With second
you're
place.
Not, you shouldn't get a trophy for coming in
well,
last.
There, it's called a participation sense. Trophy, and they don't keep score until a certain age. Everybody's winning. They don't care who wins or loses. But you see, Robert, the kids in Oxnard are going to have a rough life. So they have to learn from a young age to be survivors.
Like that movie. What's his name? Billy Crystal? What's his name? Crystal something.
Billy Crystal's the actor, yeah.
Yeah, he's an actor, right? Billy Crystal.
With the baseball team?
The baseball, he's like one of those guys that's always announcing the game.
Yeah.
He was doing it for a pro team. But then they already got rid of him because he's too old or something.
I remember
they got rid
that.
Of him. So he goes and he goes with his grandkids to spend the summer with them.
Oh, okay.
And he goes to their baseball games, and they don't keep score, so he gets mad. He's getting mad, because what do you mean you don't keep score? So what's the point of, you know, teaching the kids how to win or
that was a good
better?
Movie, I remember it.
It's a good movie.
He tried out for the X Games, and he didn't know how to broadcast the X Games.
Yep, that's a good movie.
But it's true today. Kids don't know. Look, when you were a kid, Robert, if you didn't win, you didn't get a trophy.
Yep.
Now they win, they lose, every kid has, trophies, belts. What did Alvin tell the coach, Pita?
I don't know what there, my dad said.
Oh.
What'd he say? Yeah, what are you talking about? We lost.
But he's right.
Yeah.
They sugarcoated too much.
The coaches are weird.
You don't need to punish them because they lose. And that's not the point. But to praise someone, if one person busts his ass, he deserves, win or lose, he deserves to get praised. If he truly busts his ass. But if he doesn't try and doesn't play and doesn't work, you know what? The best trophy is go back. Study again and do it again.
You just don't worry, guys. You guys did really good.
Robert, you remember once we did a video with the kids from Oxnard in the gym and they were all cursing. They were like 4 years old, 5 years old. And they were like, fuck you, fuck this, fuck. And everybody got mad.
Yeah.
But you don't understand. It's a way to adapt to life. It's being mentally strong at a very young age and understand life's not easy.
Yeah.
It's a survival thing. And they'll adjust to society much better.
Growing up in the Colonia area, in Oxnard, they have to learn how to survive. Those kids, they can be...
Well, that's your first lesson is survival.
Yeah.
And then you go from there, kind of.
But if you're sugar-coated as a baby, you'll never adapt. Yeah. You'll be an adult and you won't realize what's wrong. And
you're always going to be that one kid that everybody picks on.
Yep.
Everybody...
And if someone picks on you, you don't know how to answer. But if you're 4 years old and they say, go F yourself, and you answer, you stand for your ground.
There's always... No matter how thin you slice it, there's always two sides, right? And you can be a little bully, and that's not the answer either. No one's saying that.
No.
But giving the full effort, trying. If you lose, you lose. Go back to the drawing board, learn again. But don't get excited because you were able to show up.
No.
No matter, I mean, even in your job, you want to do a better job than the guy next to you, right? You want to do better interviews. You want to be at better places, get more people to talk to you or watch you. So if you beat the other guy up, doesn't mean you're trying to hurt him. You just want to make sure you're the best.
I stay in my lane, doctor. I don't get in other people's lane.
You stay in your lane?
I stay in my lane. Rodolfo, you understand everything I say, so why don't you speak English?
Lindolfo.
What kind of name is Lindolfo?
German. Rodolfo, but with a...
With the L-I-N. Lindolfo? Your parents like Jeremy Lin?
His dad is Lindolfo, his grandfather is Lindolfo too.
So it runs in the family. Is he the only boxer in the family?
Es el único boxeador de la familia.
Mi papá, pero fue amateur.
His dad was an amateur fighter.
Was he good?
Sí, invicto.
Undefeated.
Wow, how many fights?
48.
He said two, asshole. How many? 48?
48 peleas amateur.
That's a lot of fights.
That's a lot of fights.
You got to beat it too, yeah.
Especially in Mexico.
Yeah.
The judge is the uncle, the ref is the grandfather, and it's true. I know.
So what did you think of Pacquiao's decision?
First, I thought it was robbery, but it's a close fight. And
I see the fight again. And he won. He won, but it wasn't like a real robbery, you know, type of fight, you know, where you know... It was bad. The guy was just tough. Kept coming in. So he worked to get that. You know, uh-huh. He worked his ass to get that decision. I'm not saying he earned it. I'm not saying he won it. But he worked his ass off to fucking.
So you've seen worse decisions.
Yes.
Yeah, and it was close and ugly, and the ref didn't enforce all the rules in the ring, and the corner of Manny's corner had no answer, nothing. They didn't bring anything to the ref's attention. Yeah. They didn't do their job.
They didn't scream at the ref and say, hey, let's do this, let's do that.
No, nothing. They stayed quiet. They said they had a mess in the corner. Well, whose fault is that?
I've been in a corner with Robert when he screams at the ref and he's our friend.
Hey, you got to stand up for your fighters.
Absolutely.
A fighter can't argue with the ref.
No. That's the corner's job. Not to be obnoxious again, but to call attention to things that are not going the way they should. And most of the refs really just miss it a little bit. They aren't there. How many refs really are there to screw up the fight? They're there to do the best they can. They want to look good no matter who they are. Some of the guys miss things, and it's...
Some of them are really good, and one day
they just happen to miss it.
They get old sometimes. It happens. Yeah. Just like that ref in the Bradley fight. He's a nice guy. Bradley Jesse Vargas.
Oh, yeah.
He said he didn't hear the bell.
Yeah.
In his head, he heard it 10 seconds before it happened.
Right. Yeah, and that was a bad decision.
Or the other one too, a young one that's actually really good too, but the one that disqualified one of our Russians. And he could have easily, you know, maybe taken a point away or because he was way on the other side of the...
He didn't see it in the ring.
And he called it a disqualification, you know, a kid, a prospect. Yeah. That
give him, I mean, it didn't hurt the Russian guy, no. But give him the benefit of the doubt there and say, hey, go sit in the corner for a while. And,
so there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekpak, reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter, @Sekpak. And you can follow me on Instagram, @Ellie Sekpak.